There are two scripts to do install and update in the examples for the distribution. I use them as an installer one for installing modules and an updater one for telling you what modules are out of date and allowing you to update them. But you can use it directly in the CPAN terminal. I would switch on that option which switches off the updating. That way it doesn't even fetch the indexes. It tells it, yeah, effectively, everything's cool, the indexes are up to date, because we're effectively delegating all that work to the CPAN IDX website to work. And then you just set source engine to be that and say that you have to install it first. It doesn't have any dependencies, it doesn't need LWP or etc., because I'm bundling HTTP Lite in the module, so I don't even have to have any dependencies. And then you save it. And then you should be able to just install modules. You've got to have internet access though. Custom source, I've got a couple of minutes. Custom sources, these are quite interesting. I've never used them myself, but I hear they're quite funky. You can add your own sources list to the index. Basically, you put your disk files in a repository, it could be an area on a website or HTTP site or even on the file system itself. It's any URL basically that C plus can understand. It has to have an index of what's in the repository. Packages.txt is called, but the backend provides a method that you can use to create that index file. And basically, when you're in the shell, you use the custom source plugin to add the URL where this packages.txt is. It just has to be the root. You just have to specify the root URL, not actually pointing to packages.txt. And you just have to have that enabled. That is the default setting, as I showed earlier. I'm just switching it off. So it just saves it doing the check to say, hey, oh, you haven't configured anything. You haven't done that bit. So it does do a check, and I don't like to see that. So that is the default, and then you'll be able to install from that custom sources directory or repository. It could be anywhere. It's something like the app sources, I think, in Debian. It's kind of on that idea. I use the app sources.
And then you can do a corporate.
Indeed, yeah.
Environment, yeah. You want to pull in a bunch of your own modules.
Indeed. So it's another way of doing what you perhaps do with CPAN Mini or CPAN Mini Inject. Inject your own stuff. So you can use this and not even have to have your own CPAN Mini rather than injecting it, just have a repository. As long as you use the CPAN Plus. Again, yeah, of course you can take advantage of CPAN Plus. Mini and CPAN Mini Inject environment. Shells and plugins. So the shells are just interfaces that provide the access to the CPAN Plus backend, which has all the logic. They're just fancy UIs, really. We've got default, which is the one that will be, if you have type CPAN P and hit enter, that's the shell you will present it with by default. But there's also classic, which is supposed to mimic CPAN.pm, the CPAN shell. That might be slightly different now because, of course, CPAN has moved on. I don't think we've updated the classic shells as much. But it hasn't changed that much. There are others available on CPAN. We've also got plugins. Plugins are available in they have to be in that namespace. Get detected using module pluggable to load in the available ones. We have remote source and custom sources. The remote plugin is quite interesting because you can basically run CPAN B shell over here. We're running the CPAN Plus daemon on another box. We're actually connecting this CPAN P over to this remote box and actually do a stop operations over here, from over here, remote controlling it from over here. So now that does work.
Yeah.
It's a use of pen. I knew I'd get a phone call somewhere. So that's it on the remote box. You run the CAMVD, setting it up to this 9.66 CS. So obviously, I'm screwed. Saying we don't have my user, we've got a super secret password. Not that the super secret password, because it's all clear text, just the white but in your CPAN shell, you would unconnect. And where were you connecting to? Oh, I didn't think that it was matched. And the other has matched. So now you're presented with a, we should say remote host. We're getting a full list of out of date modules, and we're going to install them by remote. Actually, without any intervention libraries, we're putting two commands on one level. Stuff that's available on CPAN right now, we've got all these disk modules that you can use with CPAN 2 disk. All the usual conferences is available. Seems to be a bit Linux heavy there. I've seen a lot of previous deals and all these intuitive shell things. This is actually what we did. I just wanted to do the social CPAN. I'm not used to know my card CPAN, actually, we don't want to do it on the CPAN. Questions? So I did push it in a bit.
So CPAN Plus is everything that CPAN does combine. And you said about the fact that CPAN's maintainable.
Well, I guess is it not maintainable by mere mortals?
Is it turning on CPAN which is really CPAN Plus is small or some common ways?
That's a very intriguing question.
You
see what the difference is, CPAN IDX. So, I was able to create the source engine. It took me half a day to sort of rip off your system and create the secret line and sort of tailor it to my own thing and how something released it. Well, actually, I didn't release it, but I sent it straight away. Sat on it for a long while and then somebody in the States sort of doing a big load of CPAN testing actually, so we've got something that made this room a bit faster. You know, to keep going to the, we'll have the memory overload. So, oh yeah, sure, I've got this room. So I did a dev release and then he overwhelmed with the metabase for your beta. Something some of the smart reports were really quick because there was no time lag. Loading and unloading the indexes into memory is the issue. Actually, running these out of local group, which is CPAN IDX as well, so it's even more faster. And he's going to make the SQLite back end of it. CPAN IDX really, really quick. So they came up with all these tricks to make CPAN quite faster. It was taking them 3 or 4 minutes to update CPAN indexes onto the CPAN. That's actually, I put those tricks back into the SQLite source engine, so we should be faster. I did use it for one time. I just used the CPAN IDX source engine. So the exclusive is estimates. Yeah, the CPAN IDX came out of CPAN wireless. It might be an idea of scraping HTML off search on CPAN.org. Module distributions, which is what CPAN minus was doing at the start. I told you that. I mean, no certain terms that was very funny. So he said, they can come up with something. I said, oh yeah, CPAN IDX, and then I was a bit too slow. So I do have one. I can't just write code about CPAN. He switched to that. He went ahead and wrote something in Python in the Google App Engine, which is what CPAN minus will use first off. You know, you go into the module that goes to the Google App Engine to look up the data. And if that fails, then it comes back on scraping search.cpan.org, which is fine until guys decide to change the code. Yes. Scraping, don't pass HTML around for checks. That's what CPAN is. It's great. Great algorithm. We always tell you, so if you want to do a channel, don't pass CPAN with regexes. Don't pass HTML with regexes. And use a proper module, right? You should not pass it. You get egos if there's that. Oh well, hopefully it was important to
you. Yes, thanks. Yeah. And in this side, just one question, is there also a disk option for making Windows distributions?
That's all that's on CPAN. Okay. Yes, no, sorry, but it's all that's on CPAN.
I'm not a Windows user, but no, for those people.
But what would it make? What would it make of it? Well, PAR is quite suitable because you get PAR disk on it.
Yes, true.
Oh, you mean PPMs? Do you mean PPMs?
I'm not sure, actually. I don't know what
MSI. Yeah, MSI. So MSI or something? I don't know.
MSI.
A lot of people swear on Kava application.
Yeah.
Actually, because you can make PPM, you can make PPM, or make PPD, or whatever it is, that's a particular
effect. Of
I think you can do it, it's an option that's understood by the EUMM or
something. And there's a packager who can, as a PPM, as Kava option, so you can still have option of the thing. You're flexible.
Thank you. I think it would have been straight. I was going to put Dinkins at IDX lightning talk during the session that was coming out, but Jeffrey said to me today, do you still want to do it this? I said, no, can you move it so I'm doing it tomorrow? Because I've done the slides of that one, so I'll try and get these slides online.
What's kind of behind my question?
CPAN.